Hello students, again I am here with a new topic, that is dimensional analysis for you today. This method is also known as unit factor method or factor label method. Why it is called unit factor? I will explain you by some examples. For like some values we have learned by heart from our childhood, that like 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram, 1 liter is equal to 10 deciliter, or 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. So, and this sequence which we use in our conversations from one unit to another unit, like kilo, hecto, deca, basic units, deci, centi, milli. So if you want to convert everything in gram, then it will become gram for everything: kilogram, hectogram, decagram, then gram, decigram, centigram and milligram. How can we convert these units? For example, like if you are going from left to right or right to left. So if you are going left to right, then we should multiply by 10 for each step, like from kilo to hecto, or deca to basic unit, or deci to centi. Similarly, from right to left, if you are converting the units, like if you are converting milli to centi, or deci to basic unit, or deca to hecto, we should divide it by 10 for each step. Let's understand this thing with some examples. Here I have given you some values, like 1 hectogram is equal to how many decigrams. So 1 hectogram is equal to 10 to the power 3 decigram. Let's understand how. For each step from hecto to deci, if you want to go, then if we go directly from this to this step, then how many step we have crossed? 1, 2 and 3. That means 10 into 10 into 10. So 3 times multiplied means 10 to the power 3. Similarly, if we go from right to left, like 1 centiliter is equal to how many decaliters? So from centi to deca, so we are going again 1, 2 and 3 steps, means 10 into 10 into 10. But because we are doing from right to left, so now we will divide it by the power 10 to the power 3, 1 upon 10 to the power 3 decaliters. Let's understand this by one more question. Here is the numerical part. Change 1 picometer into nanometer. Picometer and nanometer, these are the units smaller than the our basic units which we have studied here. The in this sequence, everything we will study, whatever we will study around these values. These are called basic units. Okay, so now if we consider this, 1 picometer is equal to 10 to the power minus 12 meters. This value we have to learn. I will share you some values of this sequence, how you can remember them. So 1 picometer is equal to 10 to the power minus 12 meters. And we know that 1 meter is equal to 10 to the power 9 nanometers. See here, meter is a bigger unit than picometer. That is why the power is in negative. And meter is bigger unit again than the nanometers. So we are converting from this to this. So that is why power is in positive. Now, 10 to the power minus 12. And if we see 10 to the 1 meter on the place of meter, we can put 10 to the power 9 nanometers here. So we know when the base is same and we are doing multiplication, then exponents add with each other. So 10 to the power minus 12 plus 9. And this will become minus 12 plus 9, 10 to the power minus 3 nanometer. So here is your answer. 1 picometer is equal to 10 to the power minus 3 nanometers. Now let's discuss the conversion of units by some examples. First question is 60 kilometer into meter. We have to convert. Now, we know the value 1 kilometer is equal to 10 to the power 3 by the basic conversion sequence. So, how can we make a conversion factor? Conversion factor is made by equalizing the values equal to 1. So, how can we make value equal to 1? We know 10 to the power 3 meter is equal to 1 kilometer. So now if we divide these two values, what we will get? We will get 1. But which value we should put in numerator and which value we should put in denominator? The value which we want in our answer, that is meter, that we should put in numerator, whereas what value we have to convert, that we should put in denominators. See how it works. 60 kilometer is equal to, if we say 60 kilometers, so we understand that if we multiply 60 kilometer into 1, that remains 60 kilometer only. So 60 kilometer, at the place of 1, we can put this conversion factor, that is 10 to the power 3 meter upon 1 kilometer. So from kilometer to kilometer got cancelled. Now what unit is left, which we required here? So 60 into 10 to the power 3 meters. We can convert it by scientific notation, that is decimal after one place, and you will get, when the decimal is shifted from left on the left side, then exponent power is increased by 1. So our answer is 6.0 into 10 to the power 4 meters. Let's take one more example. 55 gram into kilogram. Now the units are in opposite manner. Here from bigger to smaller, here from smaller to bigger. We know that 1 gram is equal to 10 to the power minus 3 kilogram by the conversion sequence. Again, conversion factor. What unit we want in our answer? Kilogram. That will be in the numerator, and the value which we want to convert, that will be in the denominators. How can we get one value of 1? That is by dividing these values. So 10 to the power minus 3 kilogram upon 1 gram. We use this conversion factor with the given value, that is 55 gram is equal to 55 gram multiplied by 1. That will be, means 1, that will be again 55 gram. So on the place of 1, we will put this conversion factor, 10 to the power minus 3 kilogram upon 1 gram. Gram to gram cancel. Again, 55 into 10 to the power minus 3 kilogram. Scientific notation, decimal shifts from on the left side, it becomes plus 1 in the exponent power. Minus 3 plus 1 becomes minus 2. So our answer is 5.5 into 10 to the power minus 2 kilograms. Now let's see some more example. One more example is here. That is, we want to convert 100 micrometer to decimeters. Micrometer, we know 1 micrometer is equal to 10 to the power minus 6 meters. And 1 meter is equal to 10 decimeters. These are the very basic value which mostly people know. Now, 1 micrometer is equal to, when we want to convert from here to decimeter, these values will get multiplied. So 10 power 1 will be added here, and it will become 10 to the power minus 5 decimeter. Now the conversion factor, 1 micrometer is equal to 10 to the power 5 minus 5 decimeter. We divide these values, we will get value equal to 1. We will use 1 equal with 100 micrometer, that is 100 micrometer into 1 will be 100 micrometer. At the place of 1, we will put these conversion factor here. Micrometer to micrometer cancel. 100 into 10 to the power minus 5 decimeter. 100 we can write like 10 to the power 2. Powers get add up in multiplication, but 2 plus minus 5 will become 2 minus 5. So the answer is 10 to the power minus 3 decimeter. Here I will share you some sequence which I have prepared for you people, so that you can see this here. Tera, giga, mega, kilo, hecto, deca, basic units, then deci, centi, milli, micro, nano, pico. These are the some basic units, or you can say prefixes, with the basic units which we use for the conversion. And these are the values. If you want to take a screenshot, you can take and note down for your notes. Thank you.